What's up everyone, my name is Faizur Rehman and welcome back to in my new video. And in this video we're gonna learn how to use Auto-Animate in Adobe XD, and also gonna give you a beautiful example how I made this beautiful carousel by using Auto-Animate in Adobe XD. So without wasting more time, let's jump into the Adobe XD. So in this video, we're gonna learn lots of great things about Auto-Animate, and I'm gonna tell you lots of great things from the basics to advanced, and also gonna create together this interactive carousel. So I think this video gonna longer and teach you every single thing about Adobe XD. So before this, if you don't know about Auto-Animate, Faz, what you're talking about, I never heard about this thing, how it works. This is an amazing feature of Adobe XD, and it's allow you to create beautiful transitions, or you can call animation, between two artboards. So simply you can convert your property into the animations, like if you have first artboard, you simply duplicate your artboard and then suddenly you'd make some changes like color, font, size, or transformation, and then after this you can easily call the Auto-Animate property to make the transition between two artboard. It's quite simple, and I'm gonna give you three examples over here to teach you every single thing about those triggers. First thing, I'm gonna talk about this simple trigger over here, the tap trigger, and how it's work. So let's start from this video. So as you can see, this is my first slide over here, and it's quite simple. And now I'm going into the prototype mode over here, you can see, and you can see, and now I'm going to duplicate this artboard simply. So because I already made this thing, and just go back to the design, and now I'm going to make some modification in my artboard. Like example, I'm going to put this thing down like this, and also just going to give some little bit border radius around it. And let's see, change the color also. Boom, that's fine. And now go back to in your prototype mode, and it's simple. And just click on this, your rectangle. And now you can see small icon over here, the arrow is coming. And there are two ways to connect your artboard. So first of all, you can drag this thing on this, it will connect. And the second one, you can click on this tab, and then you can give whatever you want. So let's start from the dragging. So I drag on this, and there are three triggers: tap triggers, drag triggers, and voice trigger. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about tap, drag, and time trigger. I'm gonna show you time trigger later. So in the action, you always remember to use Auto-Animate if you wanna make beautiful transitions again. And now I'm going to use easing none because I don't know it. And let's give some more timing, like whatever timing suitable, like 6. That's awesome. And let's see. Click on the play button. We have our preview window in Adobe XD. Now I'm gonna hit the click on this box. Boom. Now you can see how easily you made your first transitions by using Auto-Animate. And now let's do something else inside this. I'm gonna change my easing with bouncing, and it is fine. And let's see how it's gonna come. Click on this. Boom. Look how beautiful it's coming. It's very quite easy. Now let's jump into your second one, is a trigger drag. I'm gonna use drag trigger over here. So as you can see, I created my two artboard already, and here is some modification like zoom effect. I'm gonna select this one and drag on this one, and now this time I'm gonna choose the drag trigger. It's simple, right? And now let's see, click on the play button. Boom, how beautiful it is. And also you can apply the same thing, like you can select this thing and go back to on this artboard. Simple, nothing to do, just go back, select your artboard, click on play button. Boom, boom. This is quite easy, right? And you can make beautiful animation by using tiny property. Let's talk about something new over here, like time. What is time? As you can see, I made this thing, and this one is your second. Right now, what I'm going to do, I'm not going to connect this thing. So just remember one thing, this is very important. Timer always work with the artboard, not with the objects. Okay, So just select your whole artboard. Now you can see tiny arrow is coming. Just drag this arrow on the artboard where you want to connect, like this. And now click on the triggers. You will see new one time. You click on this time, and now you have delay property. Select the auto animate, and now you just give the any time if you want to give like 4 seconds, let's say. Click on this and click on play button. Boom. So it's coming like I didn't realize it's coming or not. So let's see something like 8 and click on this. Wow, it's coming. It's beautiful. So this is how you can create beautiful loader timer or lots of great things, and it's very useful. So I'm gonna back this thing on this, going to same property, like as you can see. Now let's see what happened. Now we made a beautiful loop. Ting tong ting. So you can see it's coming beautiful. Going, coming, going, coming, going, coming. That's how you can build beautiful animation by using these three properties. And yep, and the voice control I'm gonna talk about in next video. And let's jump into the main tutorial. So now I hope you have a good understanding about animation, how the Adobe XD made beautiful transitions for you, and now you can use it in your design. Let's jump into this tutorial. This is amazing, and you can see I have all things. I already said this thing, and here is my wallpapers. As you can see, three wallpapers, simple, nothing is here. And this one is my review kind of thing, or talking about the product, whatever you want to say. And this one is your indicators. Okay, so I'm gonna animate every single thing in this video. So the first of all, I will tell you a few things while I'm creating this thing. Always remember when you are doing this thing. So please just be focused. And so first of all, just drag this thing over here. So first thing, I'm gonna mark this property over here. So remember this thing. If you don't know about the masking, it's a good point to learning for you how to mask in Adobe XD. So just select together both things and click on the object. And now you will see the marks with shape. Now it's fine. And how to edit it? It's very simple. Just double click on this and then you can edit your marks property. That's simple. Take this wallpapers, just scale a little bit because I want to see a little bit scale effect in my carousel. So like when it will be activated, it will come in default condition, default size, not big size. So I selected already, just cut this thing and double click on this and paste over here and drag over here. Now middle align, you can see the smart guidelines is working great job over here. And now we have this thing, pretty cool. One thing I wanna share with you over here. Remember when you're making this kind of carousel or into the Adobe XD, just group all property together. So as you can see right now, I have this image, I have this one. I'm going to take this wallpaper inside my group, or maybe I can do ungroup and group again like this. That's it. And after this, I'm gonna call this property over here simply like this, and also this property. So I have to do some measurement over here. I always trying to make beautiful pixel perfect design, so I never compromise with my pixels. So this is kind of like I'm doing. Okay, so 60 pixel from here, as you can see, and from the down, just select this one and go down like this. And I think we are almost done. And now I have to say something else to you guys. Just first of all, I'm going to take this thing inside my group, because when I move my wallpaper, this should also move that time. So just cut this thing over here and double click in your marks and just paste over here. So now you can see this thing inside my marks over here, my properties. Okay, and now one more thing I want to do. I want to paste this thing also over here. So just copying this thing and pasting over here. Oops, something I did. like this, like 60 pixel as I told you before. Yeah, and one more thing, I want to give kind of like a slide up and slide down effect. So by default condition, I'm putting this thing into down. So when the slide will be activated, it automatically come up and it will gonna look good. So yep, like this, good. And just going to paste this thing again on this wallpaper. So now you can see I places my review section on every wallpaper, as you can see over here. Now the important tips for you guys. Remember, when you're doing auto animate, you should always use different names of your layers. Otherwise, it's not gonna run if the name are similar. So example, as you can see right now, I have my names. So I'm gonna change this thing like 2 and 3. Because I had this problem, I was trying to do the animation, but it was not working. That's why I thought I should share with you, and it's gonna help you a lot. So I think we're almost done. Now we are going just copying this thing. Now just simply select your all things over here. Just double click on this, and you can see all property like this. Select. And select. And remember, we should not move the marks, because this is a mark. This property rectangle is coming. Either you can give the name to know exactly what you're moving. So right now I'm moving this thing, like you can see my wallpaper and everything beside my marks. So it's quite simple, kind of this thing. Yep, we almost done. Now I'm going to resize my wallpaper. Just double click on this, resizing like this. It's quite simple. You can make very, very quick. I know. And now we're gonna move this thing also. Okay, so that's fine. So first thing, I'm gonna check this thing is working or not. So let's come into the prototype mode. And now you can see we have 2 artboard already. So let's see how it is coming. So first thing, how we can do the prototype of this carousel. So just remember, just double click on this. If you remember in the beginning of video, I said to you, just make a group of your images, right? So we are going to select this group and going to drag this group over here. Okay, and now just change the any trigger as a drag trigger and auto animate. That's fine. And let's see it's working or not. Click on play. Boom, it's working. So finally we have done this thing. It's great job. Let's see once again. Zoom effect is coming like this. Wow, that's amazing. We're gonna make more changes over here. So first thing, I'm gonna work on this thing, just putting down, because I want some kind of animation. And the transparency 0. So here you can make changes in transparency, like opacity, like kind of thing. And now I'm putting this thing on the top like this. But I think I have done silly mistake over here. So I'm gonna tell you what mistake I have done. So in the beginning, I should have this zero the opacity transparency. So now I can easily make the transparency 100. So let's see if it's gonna work or not. So oops, let's select on this one. Yep, first one. And let's see if it's gonna work or not. Yep, you can see it's the transparency, it's coming up. So it's very important if you wanna give like beautiful smooth effect, like coming and going. So now I'm gonna make some changes over here. So let's make this thing beautiful, like interactive. So remember one thing over here, this is a pro tip for you. If you are using auto animation, please don't move anything. Like if you think if you will move this thing over here, it will work. It will not work. And so for this, I'm going to make this thing 16 pixel and this one is 32 indicator. Now like this. And the second tip I'm gonna give you right away. So example, if you wanna paste this thing, this all property on this, it's quite simple. First of all, copy, just go in edit, copy, and you can also use shortcut and select this property, this object, go again in Adobe XD and select this paste appearance, and it will put all effect whatever you have in your next layer, it will copy exact thing on your selected object. Okay, fine. And now let me do this thing. That's it, we're done. Now we're going back to my our prototype mode, and then just going to click on this and click on this again. Now you will see this beautiful. Now you can see it's working beautiful. So next thing, I'm gonna repeat this process. Now this time I'm just going fast forward. But before looking the preview, I'm gonna tell you over here something. So in this carousel last slide, I wanna make something different. So I'm going to put over here tap trigger beside putting the drag trigger. So now again, we're gonna do this thing. Just open this your whole image. You can see this group, and always remember you have to do you have to work like this, because sometimes it's not work, because I tried a lot. And now let's drag this thing on this simply. Now I'm going to take the tap behavior, simple and that. And now let's see on the duration is like a 6-8. Okay, fine, no problem. Let's see the example how it's gonna work. So just you, as you know, first trigger we have is a drag, boom, and second trigger, yep, it's looking beautiful. And now you can make some changes over here, like example, let's say I'm gonna change something over here, like clicking on this drag bar. I'm gonna give you some kind of wind up animation. I love wind up. It's a, and the second one, I'm gonna give you some kind of like 1 second, and just going to give again wind up. And the last thing I'm gonna give, as you remember, we learn about the timer, right? So now I select my whole artboard and just put this thing on the top to make repeat again and again, like this. Now timer, right? We can say like delay for wait for 0.6 second. Okay, great. Wind up, okay, duration is 1 second. Let's see how it's gonna look. This is final one. So now first one is a drag, great. And the second one is a boom. You can see it's working beautiful. Once again. So that's amazing. I really love it when I was creating this thing for you guys, and I really love this feature, and I'm gonna make lots of great things for you. And the second thing, if you need this file, I already put this file into my description. You can go and check out the old tutorial in this file, and I hope you're gonna learn lots of great thing, and you're gonna make something beautiful. Also, if you create something, let me know on my Instagram by tagging me. If you need my Instagram account, you can find my Instagram account below, where I'm uploading daily basis something new, tricks, tips for you guys. And let me know what you create by using Auto-Animate. I hope it was a great journey when you're watching my video, and I hope you learned something new of how to create a beautiful animation by using Auto-Animate. And if you like my video, please hit the like button. And if you are new watching to me, just hit the subscribe button. And if you have any question, if you have any suggestion, and if you want to know anything new, let me know in the comment. And guys, I'll see you in next video.